Hi everyone, welcome back to SGK English Elementary English Grammar. I hope you have revised the lessons that we saw yesterday and before. What we saw yesterday was the use of do, does, did, how to use it, etc. Today let us see the use of how. As you know, there are three primary auxiliaries. Auxiliaries are of two types. See, auxiliary means helping verb. Okay, now they are primary auxiliaries and modal auxiliaries. Primary auxiliaries are three: be, do, and have. The difference is that these primary auxiliaries can be used as finite as well as auxiliary verb. They can be used as a finite as well as auxiliary verb. That's the difference. Other auxiliaries, it cannot be used in such a way. Okay, let us learn today's part. So how, you know the form have, has in present. See, has for singular, have for a plural, and had in past tense. Has, have, had. Maybe, okay. So has, have, had. There is a use of, there is a, I mean, a forms of a have. So how it is used? See, number one, as a finite verb, this word have can be used as a finite verb or regular verb in the sense of possess. I possess something. For example, we have a car. I have a pen. I have a pen. She has a book. Have, has, had also. I had a car few years ago. I had a bike few years ago. Now I don't have it. Or I am not having it at present. Okay, now I had. So as a finite verb, as a regular verb, there is no other verb, isn't it? So see, verb, kriya, the I mean activity or the subject. Okay, now so in the sense of what? Possess. I possess. We have a house here. Here we have a house of our own, not rented house, pakka house. Okay, now yes, have in the sense of what? Possess, possession. Have you got a pen? Yes, I have, sir. Have you got a textbook with you? Yes, I have. I bring it every day. Is it not so? You bring textbooks every day and notebooks too. English especially, you bring every day now. Yes, I remember. Yes. Have you got? Have you? There is auxiliary. Okay, now. Yes. You see, have you got? The auxiliary we are coming to. You see, I have a pen, I have a book, we have a car, etc., etc. Now that is the first use. Second one, as an auxiliary to make questions. Have you seen the cinema, drishyam? Have you seen the cinema? Nice cinema you see once. Okay. Nice movie you can see once if you get time. Have you seen? Have you seen? Here it is auxiliary, this is a verb. Have seen is a verb. Here this is auxiliary. This is a finite. That means have seen. Present perfect. Tense we will study later. Okay. So as an auxiliary to make questions. Have you ever gone to America? Yes. Or no, I have not. I have not gone. Okay, now. As an auxiliary to make questions. And third one, again as an auxiliary to form perfect tense. To form perfect tense. I have written. I have written, I shall have written, he has written, he had written, he will have written. Perfect tense to form, this have is used. See, these three are very simple to understand. But sometimes it will be asked in the same sentence as finite and auxiliary. See, take for example, the example of do that we saw yesterday. Did you do the exercises? Did you do the homework? So, for example, did you do the homework? So did you do? This is auxiliary, this is finite. I did do means I did it. If you have done it, is it not so? Did you do the exercise? Did you do the homework? Yes, we did it or I did it. Okay, now here is auxiliary, here it is a finite. In the same way, how is used. See, let us see that, for example, How you had your dinner? This is very important. Because you cannot ask someone that did you eat your dinner. Very impolite that is. See, how your dinner please? Have it please. If you want to give someone something, suppose some sweets or something, you if you have it please. When you give, don't say take it, no. Especially, dinner, any meals, bhojanam, whatever, you see, don't say eat your dinner or did you eat your dinner, no. You see, have you had your, see this is past tense of this have. Have you had, it's actually present perfect. Have you had your dinner? How will you say answer? Yes, I have had my dinner. That's difficult part, no? I have had. How plus V3 of have. That is again hard. V3 of have is also hard, you know. How hard, hard. How is present, hard is past. Past to participle also hard. So, I have had my dinner. That means present to perfect. You can say in past also, I had my dinner. Past to perfect. It is not a printing mistake. You see in some sentences, I had my dinner yesterday. Okay, I had past perfect. And yesterday cannot be used. Yesterday means past simple. Okay, had can be used as past perfect. See, how you had your dinner is a nice usage of asking someone whether you have eaten your dinner. Have you had your breakfast now? Have you had your breakfast? Yes, I have had. Yes, I had means still past simple. Tense you are studying in detail, then you will learn it. Don't worry about that. So, it is used as auxiliary as well as finite. Auxiliary as well as finite in the same sentence. It can be used. And remember that this have is best way, polite way of asking someone to take something or receive something. See, have it please. You offer something now, you give some sweets on your birthday. You cannot say, and don't tell others, take it, no. Have it please. Have it please. So, you are giving a birthday, a party to your friends. You can ask, have you had it? Or, have it please. Have you had your, meals? Have you had your breakfast? Have you had your dinner? Have you had your dinner? Yes, isn't it so? I have had, you have to answer such a way. You have to answer in such a way. I have had my breakfast. I have had my dinner. I have had my meals, whatever be. So you are asking politely also, have it please, have it please. So you take some sweets and you are offering to others, you cannot say, come take. No, it is very impolite and rude, very rough and rude. Don't say that, have it please. That's a polite way of expressing or offering something. Yes, the use of have, mainly three uses. Number one, as a finite verb in the sense of possess. Possession means ownership. I have a car. Okay, now. Second one, to make questions. You know it, no? Yes. Third one, to form perfect tense that you will study as part of our studying tense. These three are the most important use of have. And above all, when you offer someone something, have it please. Yes, I hope it is clear to you. Thank you for watching. For more updates, subscribe to the channel SGK English. Thank you.